We are talking about some rain in the forecast. Let's get over to meteorologist Jeff Ray with a look at what you can expect.
Yeah, and part of our forecast is how it's cooling down after all this rain. It's because of all this cool weather that's up in the mountains. See how it's still snowing. All that snow that was further off to the west has moved a little bit east into Utah, Colorado, Wyoming, and Montana. And they're still going to snow for a couple more days at the ski resorts, some of like Steamboat Springs, maybe 10 more inches of snow there. Around here, we're talking about rain. Now, so far today, most of this has been just light to moderate rain streaming across the 45 corridor in our southeast counties and some drizzle here and there elsewhere. But there is a flash flood watch. It's issued. It goes in effect tomorrow morning. It goes all the way to Thursday evening. One of the reasons we're a little bit concerned is, believe it or not, a Pacific hurricane. Okay, a couple of things here. Tropical storm Pamela, soon to be a hurricane, and it's got 70-mile-per-hour winds moving north at 9. What I'm showing you here in pink is the track of Sandra back in November 2015. That two-day rain at DFW was 6 inches of rain because this moisture from Sandra went across Mexico and got into North Texas. And you can see how the track of Pamela is so much the same. In fact, the forecast track has come on shore as a Category 1 hurricane. Sandra was a Category 4, by the way. But all that moisture headed right into North Texas to interact with a front. So let me show you the setup. Okay, a warm front has come through. We've had these gusty winds that'll be strong through the overnight hours. We think the first good wave of rain comes in the overnight hours, and tomorrow morning, expect a wet commute. So get ready for rain as you're dropping off the kids, getting to work. Here comes the front. As we get into the evening hours, this front's going to fire up some thunderstorms. We're not expecting severe weather, but some big rains from these thunderstorms, because as the front stalls, you see all this moisture coming up from the southwest. This is the remnants of Pamela, the hurricane, and it's just going to bring all this rain across North Texas. There's Thursday morning. Here's Thursday at noon. The front's still here, and one big round of rain still to go through. I think it starts to clear up Thursday night, by the way. But when it's all said and done with, like, we have forecast models kicking out 3 to close to 4 inches of rain in some areas across North Texas. So keep in mind, we haven't had a big rain at DFW in a while. In fact, 17 months ago, a rain over 3 inches at DFW, a one-day rain, that was 17 months ago. 2-inch rain, that was 15 months ago. It was 55 days since we've had over even a 1-inch rain at DFW. So just to remind you, when these big rains come in, move to higher ground. Do not attempt to drive through flooded roads. 1 foot of water will float your vehicle. 2 feet of water will carry your vehicle away. Do never and never drive around a barricade. Now, what I most want you to know is if there's a flash flood warning for where you live, don't drive around for a couple of hours during that warning, because that's usually how long they last. Are you in a flash flood warning? Download our app. It will tell you wherever your phone is if there is a flood warning. We just have to get through a couple of days of big rain, folks. And then it gets really, really nice. The last weekend of the fair is going to be near perfect. Great fall weather finally showing up, and this time sticking around. But flash flood watches start tomorrow morning. They go all the way into Thursday night. Please drive with care. The front comes through, clears us out. Great weekend in store for us, and even a night. A morning in Sunday in the 40s. I like it. I'm going to issue a sweater alert.
Oh, a sweater alert. It's about time.